So in our last class, we have looked into this log transformation, right? And we have seen how it can affect the histogram of the image and hence the quality of the image. Then we have the power law transformation. During this log transformation, we have also discussed about this exponential transformation, okay? Which is also similar to S equals to capital C into exponential of R, okay, e to the power R. Exponential R. So these are similar things, so I will not be discussing over here again. We have already discussed that what happens when you are using exponential transformation. What happens is that your contrast in the brighter pixel region, it increases, and the contrast in the darker region, it decreases. Okay, this power law transformation, it is also similar to this log and exponential transformations. Okay, so what happens over here, S equals to C into R to the power gamma. Okay. Now, if you look over here and consider C equals to 1, so to simplify our case, so we get S equals to R where gamma is equal to 1. Okay. So, if you plot the transformation function R versus S, you will be getting something like this, the straight line. Okay. What is this? This is nothing but your identity, this thing. When R equals to, when gamma is equal to 1. Now, if you change the value of C, this slope will vary. Okay, now as you go on increasing this C value, it will be like this, but it will be a straight line. Okay, now comes when gamma is less than this one. What happens? The curve will be something like this, right? So it is similar to your exponential. It is not exactly exponential. In exponential, the contrast will be very high. So if you look over here, the exponential, it will be something like this. Suddenly it will go on increasing, but in gamma less than 1, in power law transformation, when gamma is less than 1, it will be, the change will be much more gradual. But here also you will find the contrast in the brighter region, it is better than the contrast in the darker region in the processed image. Okay, when gamma is greater than 1, it should be opposite to the logarithmic value. So it will be something like this. So this yellow graph, it is gamma greater than 1. And if you compare it with logarithmic, you will find something like this, right? So over here, what will happen when gamma is greater than 1? Contrast in the darker region will be better as compared to the contrast in the brighter region, but the effect will be much more different as compared to the, or much more salient as compared to the logarithmic values or the gamma or the exponential values, okay, depending upon which gamma you are using. Now, since over here we are changing the gamma values, and by changing the gamma values we are able to alter the quality of the image, it is also regarded as gamma processing, okay, or gamma transformation, right? Gamma transformation. So since it is similar to the logarithmic transformation, I am not going into the details of this one also here. You just get a feeling what happens over here, okay? But you can expect the numericals from this case. Next, so in gamma correction, what are the applications? Nonlinearities encountered during the image capturing, putting and displaying can be corrected using gamma correction. Okay, so suppose if there are any nonlinear lighting, or you have misplaced the object in such a fashion such that the lighting in one side is better than the other side, in those cases we will be having some what you call disc or nonlinearity in the image. That means your overall background of the image will not be equally bright. So in these cases you will be getting having that this is this gamma correction, it is helping you in a better manner. Next is our intensity level slicing. Okay, so the word is intensity level. So that means a particular level of intensities, they will be sliced. Okay, now there are two types of intensity slicing method. The first one is the without background, and the second one is with background. Okay, now what it says, S is equal to L minus 1 when our R values varies between A and B, both inclusive, otherwise it is 0. So if you look into the transformation matrix, here you are having L minus 1, here you are having L minus 1, so then you are having A and B. So in this range you are having L minus 1, and in the other region it is 0, right? L minus 1 and 0. Okay, so this is without background. Now suppose it if it is with background, then what happens? It becomes L minus 1 in the range of A to B, but in the other range it is R. Okay, so how it will look like? So this should be a straight line. Okay, so my diagram is somewhat incorrect. So this should be from here. So it will be like this. Okay, so in the previous case it is totally L minus 1, and in this case it is in this region it is L minus 1, but in the other region what is happening? It is S equals to R. So your y axis is S and this one is R. Right. So this is intensity level slicing. Okay, so please do it. Take the image and take A equals to 5 and B equals to 10 and perform the intensity level slicing both with without background and with background. So how to do this? You are given with R and you have to calculate S. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 10, is for the Sajara. So without background, in this region it will be 15 because it is a 4-bit image. Okay? And in this region it will be 0 and in the higher region it will be 0. It is for the without background. And with background, what will happen? R equal to S. Okay? So basically what is happening, suppose you are having an image okay, say you are having some soft tissue, then you are having some very dense object, say bone. Okay, so what this helps us is that suppose you, so this is having very dark background, okay, this is a very dark background, say having pixel value near to 0. This region it is having pixel value say near to L minus 1, so for an 8-bit image say 255. Now what happens is that this is your area of interest. Okay, so the this intensity level slicing, it helps us. If you see over here, it is L minus 1 and 0, it converts the thing into two parts. So this transformation, it helps us in creating a mask. Okay, so in this area which is your region of interest, you will get 255, and if you normalize it, it will be 1. Okay, and the other areas, it will be both this outside value and this inside value, this will be 0. So when you multiply this mask, because this is now a binary image, after transformation it becomes a binary image, right? So when you multiply this with the image, only the portion which you intend to analyze, that one will only be present in the picture, and the rest of the pixels, it will be out of the, it will be suppressed to 0. In other cases, over here with background, what will happen? These pixel values, this will not be a, first of all, it will not be a binary image, it will be a some array image. Okay, right? Say if it is some array image, or you can say some bit image, say it's for L minus 1, if it is 255, it will be a 8-bit image. If it is 15, it will be a 4-bit image. Okay, so only the region in this highlighted portion, in this blue highlighted portion, it will be assuming, it will be assuming a value of L minus 1. Okay, in all the other region, whatever is the background or the foreground, that will remain as such. Okay, so what happens over here, suppose you want to do some analysis in the bony image, or in the bony image part, so it will help you in concentrating in that part only, and it will help you in segregating it from the what you call from the soft tissue. Okay, now saying this, you may say, sir, what if we go for say this thresholding. Thresholding is similar to this intensity level slicing, but over here in thresholding, S is equal to L minus 1 in the region of AR L minus 1 and 0 otherwise. So, what is the transformation matrix function? Transformation function. This is R, this is L, S, L minus 1. Over here you are having L minus 1. So, you are having A over here. So, you get some function like this. So what is happening? Thresholding, it is allowing us to differentiate the image into two classes, one foreground region and one background region. But intensity level slicing, it is helping us in segregating the image in three regions. Okay, it is helping us in segregating the region in three regions. Say for example, you are having a soft tissue, then within that you are having a bony area, and at the same time you are having a tumor which is having characteristics which are similar to that of the soft tissues. Okay, so in that case what will happen? You are having three classes. So if you want to segregate the tumor part, which is the middle part, then you can go for this without background and you will be able to highlight that. But suppose you want to see what is happening to the surrounding soft tissue, then you go with the background. It will be highlighted to complete this thing, L minus 1. So your attention will be around the soft tissue region. Okay. So I cannot start with the bitplane slicing today. It will take some time. So please do this thresholding example and then we will disperse. Okay. Thresholding. You can find out the histogram and the processed image. Consider A equals to say 5.